Hi, I'm Megan, and today I'll be showing you around Algolia's Merchandising Studio. With the Merchandising Studio, business users can quickly create and modify merchandising strategies, apply running one-off updates, and let AI do some of the heavy lifting through our powerful dynamic re-ranking tool. All of this in real time through one user-friendly centralized environment. So let's jump straight in. When you enter Algolia's dashboard, to find the Merchandising Studio, you can navigate to the workplace switcher in the top right of your screen. Here you can find the Merchandising Studio and toggle over to this view. It's important to note that this interface is only available on our Premium and Elevate plans. Now we're here, let's look at the things that can be done. Starting on the homepage, you'll see a quick view of the analytics, which looks at all the data over the last 7 or 30 day windows. Typically, this information is used to identify any trends within the last week or month on your performance and quickly dig into any issues that might be underlying. In order to see more information about all of this data, we can toggle across to our analytics dashboard. Within our analytics dashboard of the Merchandising Studio, you can see all of the data that is being returned to you from your Algolia implementation. Here you can see the total users and searches, as well as other key performance indicators, such as no results rate, click-through rate, conversion rate, and purchase rate. For all of these views, you have the option to select a specific date range in which you wish to see this data. We could, for example, have a look at the last 30 days. And if we wanted to, we could even compare that to the previous 30 days. If I scroll down, I can also see some more data here. First of all, we have an easy-to-use trends overview diagram. This allows me to quickly toggle on whichever metrics I'm wanting to look at and quickly spot any peaks or troughs in the data. Click position shows us the average position of the clicks performed on search results. And at the bottom, we have the top line results for searches, results, and searches without results. Within the searches tab, we can dig into even more detail. Here, we're returned to the top 1,000 searches on your index. We also see how they're performing and can dig in for even more information. Here I can see that jacket is the number one search that's performed on this site. And if I dig into it even more, I can see the average click position, the popular results for this search, as well as any popular filters that are being used. We can do the same for searches without results, as well as searches without clicks. And all of this data can be downloaded and exported from Algolia to be used elsewhere. The additional data that we have in this Merchandising Studio is category page data. This gives us a very similar view for searches, but shows how our category pages are performing. Here we can see a breakdown on the count of users landing on the category page, the percentage of total views that this accounts for, as well as those same key performance indicators. Again, if I click into a category page, I can see even more information, having a look at click position, the popular results for this category page, as well as if there are any additional filters that are being applied. Now we understand what analytics is available, let's have a look at the real visual merchandising capabilities. Toggling across into our visual merchandising space, this is really the most powerful area of this interface. First off, we have the option to either merchandise by search experience or category page. For this first example, I'm going to try and merchandise the query for jumper. You can see I've already performed this query here, and these are what my results look like. I've decided that actually I want to make some changes, so I'm going to go ahead and curate this query. This automatically takes me into our detailed merchandising space. This is where we're creating a rule. We know that the trigger that we're trying to create a rule for is if someone types jumper into the query, and now we need to perform the actions that we're trying to achieve. For this situation, I'd like to boost the brand. And the brand I'd like to try is Polo. If I click apply, I can see that the results on the right hand side are changing to react to the strategy that I've applied on the left. And now all Polo Ralph Lauren products are shown higher up in these results. I could go a step further and do some other things. So for example, if I'd like this blue sweater to be in the first position, I could simply drag and drop it there. And on the left-hand side, you can see that the strategy updates accordingly. Once we're happy with how the results look, I can go ahead, review and publish this rule. Here, I'd like to add a description to make sure that it's as clear as possible what I'm trying to achieve with this rule. And there we have it. Our first rule has been saved and our jumpers merchandising experience has been updated. Next, I'd like to try and merchandise a category page. So here I'll toggle across to the category page experience and find the page that I want to do. Having a quick browse, I can't easily see what I'm trying to merchandise. So instead, I'll just have a type. For this example, I'd like to merchandise the men's tops page. So I've navigated to this and I can see how the results currently look. I'd actually like to remove these Kangra branded products for this time. So in order to do that, I can simply do a curate page click. And now I'm going to decide to hide items. So here I'd like to hide by attribute. And again, the brand is Kangra. So I go ahead and apply that. And you would have seen that the products have changed on the right hand side to reflect this new rule. Again, once I'm happy, I can go ahead and review and publish. And there we have another updated rule on your results. There's lots of other things that we can achieve. And if there is an existing rule, on the page that we're trying to curate, all we would do is add an additional strategy to the bottom. So here we can see that there is actually a potential conflict with this condition, in which case I can investigate what this conflict might be and try to edit this strategy instead. With this sidebar, I can also have a quick view of any existing rules to avoid that situation where a conflict might occur. We have the option between category-specific rules or global rules. Global rules apply to your entire site, whereas category-specific or search-specific rules only apply to the page that you're viewing at that time. Additionally, if we toggle up to the magnifying glass, we'll be able to see a query breakdown in the situation where we've performed a search. So if I perform a search for jacket, we could see any existing synonyms, plurals that are being considered, as well as typos too. Next, I'm going to set up a keyword redirect. Currently, I'm not happy with how the men's t-shirt results page is looking, and therefore I'd like to redirect it to one of my brand category pages. In order to do that, all I do is simply create a new rule. I go ahead and curate this query, and now I use the redirect consequence. Here I simply paste the URL that I'd like to redirect to and click apply. You'll notice that on the right-hand side, the products don't change as we've not done anything to change these. However, what we do see is a pop-up to say that the users won't see these results, but instead they will be actively redirected towards the URL that you've specified. Once again, review and publish and add a description to your rule. Next up, we'd like to have a look at no-code banners. For this experience, I'd like to merchandise a search page for jeans and add a banner into the results. To do so, once again, I would click Curate this query. And here I will be using the Display Banner consequence. For these banners, banners will only appear at the top of the results as the warning shows at the top. All we need is a URL for the banner and where it's hosted. And for optional information, you could add in some alternate text when a user hovers over. I'm just going to add jeans banner. And you could also include a target URL. So when the user clicks on the banner, they are redirected to a specific page. For this situation, I'm going to leave this blank and simply apply the banner. In this situation, you can see on the right-hand side exactly where the banner will display and how it looks in relation to the products below. If I was wanting to update the products to match the banner, I could do so all within one rule. I can now review and publish. And if I go back to have a look at my jeans page, again, in this view, I can see the banner that's now configured. As you can see, there's loads that can be done within Algolia's Merchandising Studio. If you'd like to learn more, please reach out for a demo, or alternatively, you could access our Merchandising Playbook, which gives you even more insight from a team of e-commerce experts with 50 years of experience in the field. Here we share best practices, tips and tricks on how to configure Algolia features to work best for your business.